Okay, I'm inside what is called the display barn, and as you can see, the amount of tools and everything in here is amazing. Again, this is why they give you a wristband, because to actually be able to take all of this in will literally take a day. You can read that from the glare. It says the uses of stone. All right, especially y'all out there with small children, please do what you can to find a place like this near you, or come here. Show your children, let them know. Oh well, actually I'm going backwards on these pictures, but this is just the way I'm walking. All right, these are gun stock blanks. There you go, guys. There's your jerky cutter. Powder kegs. Bullet molds. Walk back up this side. There's your mercantile and your post office. There's your barber's chair over there. There's toys for the kids. And you can imagine the candy that was in these jars. Alright, I'm gonna make a hello. Quick trip upstairs, sorry. Camera's gonna shake while I'm walking up these steps. Okay. Here's your view of where I was. And just this is just this booth is called the World of Scales. Folk art, canes, hand carved canes, obviously. Furniture. All handmade. Every bit of it. Oh, wow. Look at that. Isn't that something? And all of these are made out of gourds. All of these are made out of gourds. These are all hand-carved puzzles. Deal is with Cedar Creek Charlie. He had a thing for dots. Dolls. Cedar Creek Charlie was born in 1894. One of 11 children. Sorry about the glare from these fluorescent lights. This is fish gigs. Traps. my traps. I'm saying it would take so long just to be able to read, learn the history. That are into ironwork and forging, boy, you need to come see this stuff. Sorry, I keep getting into dark areas. And I don't know if y'all can see it yet. Look up there. Look at all that. It's everywhere. Everywhere. And over here. There you go. Here's your beehives. There's your bee bonnet. These wax mold up there in the corner. Old chainsaws. Oops, sorry. Again, I apologize. Going in and out of light. These are augers. Your water pipes. Pipe augers. Oh, he's not looking too healthy. Well, I can't get my light good there. Here we've got bottles and churns. bull blind. Milking stools. Alright, I'm gonna head back downstairs. Let me give y'all one more glance around at everything up here. Yeah, well, let's go back down. I need to go back out this way, get out. Yeah, like I said, there's your post office courthouse. And this is the Cooper's House, which is a religious exhibit. Items in here. Yep. This is a wooden motorcycle. Yep. And a wooden bicycle. Okay. The upstairs of this is closed off. This appears to be a schoolroom. And here's dominoes and all right. I'm trying to see what time it is. Big brown jug, yeah, I'd say it is. It's 3,000 pounds. It's 7 foot tall. Holds 750 gallons. Yeah, that's big. Okay. This is the saddle shop. That's called the upping block. Yep, they'll one up you on that. Okay, cabin number 10. There's the well. And it says that this is the... Here where you can read. This is the Mark Twain family cabin. And when I paid for my ticket, they said all these buildings were original to within a 200-mile radius of here. They've all been dismantled and reassembled here, many of them with the original furnishings. And that goes up to the loft up there, but it's roped off, so I can't. This was moved from Possum Trot in Fentress County. Yeah, you can see what the cabin looked like when they were moving it. This is how you live simply. Oh, guess we go this way. All right. Guess that would probably be the corn crib. And there's the side door of the cabin. And I've still got a whole lot of ground to cover, and I'm not going to be able to do it all. Get in the light. Okay, this is the garden. An old building there. This is the Bunch Smokehouse. So this is General Bunch House. This is her pantry. There's stairs that go up. There's beds back there. This, look at the high chair. The bench. An old crutch hanging next to the door. Back porch. It's the baby's bed. Imagine there's beds upstairs. That's a hollowed out log. A couple of them. This is the old sharp mill. That's where they made cornmeal. Those stones. Alright, I'm 5 foot tall. That's probably 30 inches at least. Alright. right. All right. Y'all see the size of that tree? That thing's at least 7 feet tall, if not eight. I'd say that's 8 feet in diameter. Bird's nest. There's barrels up there. This is the McClung house. Well, this is a big home. This really is. Wedding dress hanging there. It's a dog trot. This is really, really spacious. Really spacious. Love the breeze that you get. These dog trot houses. Here's the door that goes into the other side. All right. Moving along. All right. Y'all know, since I don't know anything about editing, that everything you're going to see here is just as it is. Okay, this is Mark Monroe Kitchen and Smokehouse. Yep, well, I see bathtubs in there. Yep, I sure do. There's a blacksmith shop. Hey, Ivy Forge. Go, buddy. Now that's an anvil. Things at least 30 inches. At least 30 inches. Let's see if I can get him up here. Yep. Blacksmith and wheelwright shop. Let's go over here. This is the broom and rope house. Broom winder. That says broom winder. De-seeder. Yep. Cox corn crib. In-house and lot. There's chickens in there. I don't think y'all can see that. Doc Randall's old medicine show. Pills, tonic, and music. Yep. Thank you. Black crows remind me of the movie Cold Mountain. All right. This is the Daniel Boone cabin here, coming up on. Dirt floor, two beds, table, long table, fireplace, yep, another chicken coop. This is Appalachian woods wildflowers.